Attorney General Bonta, you helped write this legislation, SB2. We're seeing it once again here. And I just want you to make the case for it. Why will this legislation, if it's passed, benefit the people of California, make them safer?
Right now, we are in a time of pain and hurt and anguish, given some of the mass shooting tragedies we've seen across the nation and right here in California, Half Moon Bay and Monterey Park. And it's incumbent upon us as leaders to do everything in our power that's constitutionally permissible to protect the lives of Californians from senseless gun violence. And we had a U.S. Supreme Court decision that came down last summer that for the first time provided a new interpretation of the Second Amendment. And we had a concealed carry weapon law in the state of California, a portion of which was struck down by that U.S. Supreme Court decision called Bruin last summer. We had to remove the proper cause or good cause component of the law and focus on two areas that will keep people safe. One, making sure that there is a robust safety evaluation of individuals seeking a concealed carry weapon permit by looking at their backgrounds, their arrest and criminal history, their restraining orders, making sure that they have they are properly trained in the handling and use and storage of a firearm, other appropriate reviews to ensure safety. And then we identified what are called sensitive sites, places where a concealed carry weapon should not be brought because children play there or go to school there, or because alcohol is served there, or because other very important constitutional rights are expressed and used there. And this bill does exactly what Bruin required. It keeps people safe. We know that more guns in more places means more gun violence and more lives lost to senseless gun violence. We also know that when you have no permitting requirements, like in so-called right to carry states, or when you have less restrictive, less robust permitting requirements, more people die and there's higher levels of gun violence. So this is an important contribution to a set of laws in California that have led California to having some of the strongest gun safety laws in the nation, as well as one of the lowest firearm mortality rates in the nation. It's part of our fact-based, evidence-based commitment to keep people safe and to keep them protected from senseless gun violence.
All right, so you mentioned the Bruin decision there. The legislature tried to take this up during the last session. You were on the floor at the 11th hour trying to get those votes, and it died. I believe it was two votes shy of passing, and the governor said in his press conference this week, you were standing there right there with him. He said, I will sign this bill. Well, it's got to get out of the legislature in order for him to sign it. We had a lot of new members this time around, Democrats that have said, you know, gun legislation is important to them. Are you more confident this time around that this will make it out of both chambers?
I'm confident, and I look forward to the governor signing a bill that the legislature has passed. And last year, on the last night of session, and I've been in many last nights of session as an assembly member, having served for 9 years, we had the votes until we didn't have the votes. And there were people who vote for every single gun safety law that is put before them, but they didn't vote for it that night. And they'll have to live with their vote and the consequences of their vote. But I am confident that we have the votes this year on this bill. I deeply appreciate the leadership of Senator Portantino, the author, the governor, and his active involvement, support, and push on this bill. And I'm proud to be part of the team that's pushing it as well, and look forward to the governor soon signing it.
And as I understand it, last session, one of the big sticking points that divided Democrats was this urgency clause. And just for folks, if the bill gets a two-thirds vote in both chambers, then it will be fast-tracked to becoming law. And that seemed to be a sticking point dividing Democrats. I know Senator Portantino said in the press conference this week, it's not included in this version, but he's not opposed to adding it. Where do you stand on that?
Right where he stands, that the bill currently does not have an urgency clause. It doesn't have a two-thirds vote threshold to put the law into place as soon as it's signed and to put it into effect as soon as it's signed. But should there be a time in the future where we think an urgency clause is appropriate to include, the door's not closed on that. But we don't have one now, and I think that's the right place to start.
No surprise to you that this is getting criticized from folks on the other side of the aisle. And of course, some gun rights advocacy groups saying that this infringes on the Second Amendment. And it also punishes lawful gun owners, responsible gun owners in the state of California. What do you say to that?
Say it does the opposite. It is exactly compliant with the U.S. Supreme Court's pronouncements as set forth in Bruin on the Second Amendment. The court says we are not in a regulatory straitjacket in California or in any state to take common sense, constitutionally compliant steps to keep people safe. They also said that we can keep concealed carry weapons from being brought into certain sensitive places. We've done that in our bill. They said you can have a robust safety evaluation to make sure that individuals who are proven to be safe and not disqualified because of their lack of safety can have a weapon. We've done that as well. So we believe we are entirely compliant with the Bruin decision. This bill is designed to be and was written to be compliant with the most recent U.S. Supreme Court pronouncement on the Second Amendment. And we believe that we've accomplished something that is both constitutionally permissible and saves lives and keeps people safe from senseless gun violence.
All right, I want to take a left turn now and ask you an unrelated question to the subject matter we've been discussing for the past couple of minutes. Your name has been thrown out there as a possible candidate to run for Dianne Feinstein's seat if she does not seek re-election for the Senate here in California, the U.S. Senate spot. Is that something you're considering? Do you want to be the senator representing California?
I'm honored that my name was mentioned and has been mentioned. I think that the U.S. senators from the state of California that we've had in the past and currently and whoever they may be in the future will be outstanding and have been outstanding representatives of our state and our values. And I just got elected to a full 4-year term as California Attorney General. And I'm focused on doing the important work of this office to keep people safe and to lift them up and improve their lives, address injustice, and solve problems. And I am not ruling anything out for the future for other opportunities that may emerge, when they emerge, if they emerge, to serve more people in different ways. But for now, I'm very focused on being California's Attorney General, proud, honored, and privileged to serve in this role, and gonna be doing my best every day that I have this job.
All right, that's not a hard no. Attorney General Rob Bonta, we appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics, as always. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.